Hello, welcome to my talk on some simple mathematical tricks for the harmonic series. Recently, I read some history books on science and mathematics, and I was fascinated by those stories and the wisdoms on how the mathematician solved those challenging problems and how the mathematical method have been established as we have seen and used today. In this talk, I will introduce a simple mathematical series and I will show how the challenging problem can be solved. So in this talk, I will first answer the question, why the mathematical series are so important? And then I will give an example to show a simple solution for the geometric series, a very simple question. And I will use graphics to show whether the harmonic series is convergent. And then a theoretical proof for the harmonic series. Finally, I will show two interesting mathematical tricks on the harmonic series. I hope my talks on the series would give you some interesting stories in the history of science and mathematics, as well as to provide you some problem-solving skills. This would be especially important in the computer age, since we have already heavily relied on the computer for solving our problems, and we have less and less used our wisdom to solve the problem. Strictly speaking, a mathematical series can be either finite or infinite. However, it is the infinite series which is so fascinating. And there are a lot of famous mathematicians who had worked on such fascinating series. This include Newton, Leibniz, Bernoulli, Euler, etc. And this would be the topic of this talk. You will see from my talks, the mathematical series are actually very important in the history of mathematics and science. And I will tell how we can use the series to illustrate how the famous mathematician solved the problem, the challenging problem, to provide the basis for the calculus development as Newton and Leibniz did, to formulate the famous number and the special function, such as Newton, Leibniz, or not, etc., and to represent the widely used approximations to all functions, such as the Taylor series, Fourier series. Take an example of a geometric series given as this, and I will show briefly how we can solve this mathematical problem. Solving the problem is quite easy. We can group all the terms together except the first term as this in the black brackets as this. And we can take the half out of the bracket. We can see a new geometric series is constructed in the brackets. So we can simply express the series as this. And we have the equation for this geometric series. So the solution for the geometric series is S equaling to 2. So we have the geometric series. The result is 2 given by this expression. An interesting and challenging series would be the simple harmonic series given as it is. So this series is basically based on the natural numbers. It would be the simplest series in formulation. Obviously, this harmonic series has the following features. The term would vanish in the infinite term of the series when n approaches to infinite. The series would increase with the number capital N, see the table here, and from n equaling 1 to 1000, the sum of the series would be 1 to 7.48. If we draw the series, we can see the curve given as this. This result are from the calculation on a personal computer. Use the computer, we can easily to calculate the series to a very large number. For instance, it would take a few seconds to calculate the series to capital N equaling to 100 million or 10 power of 8. From the plot, we can see the increase would be slowed for large capital N. It looks this series would converge to a certain value. Is this true? If so, what is the value of the series? In here, we can compare the harmonic series and the simple geometric series. This is the plot for the harmonic series, the same plot as the one we see in the previous slide. And for the geometric series, the plot is given as this. So we can see both series would increase with the increase of capital N. But then always difference is that in the geometric series, the increase is very quick and converged to the number 2, see here. Now, if we draw the plot in a different way, we use logarithmic axis for the number capital N. So we can see clearly the increase of the geometric series for the small number n less than 8. And we can see here the geometric series converges when the capital N is equaling or larger than 8. See here. If we plot the series for the harmonic, we see very different picture here. The harmonic series is increased with the number capital N. Here, we calculated the series up to 100 million. The chance is always the series is almost linearly increased with the logarithm of the number capital N. So, from this plot, we can conclude the harmonic series would not converge to a certain value. It would be infinite. We have shown graphically that the harmonic series is infinite, meaning the harmonic series is divergent. In here, we will prove mathematically that this harmonic series is indeed an infinite. In this slide, a simple proof will be given on why the harmonic series is infinite. First, we group the terms together in the brackets, two terms here, and four terms in here, and eight terms in here, and so on. Now, we use some smaller value to replace some terms in the series, such that the sum of the series would become smaller. That's why we have the larger than sign here. If we look at here, we use 1 over 4 to replace 1 over 3. Here, 1 over 8 to replace 1 over 5, 1 over 6, and 1 over 7, and so on. So if we calculate this value in the brackets, we have all half in the brackets. And for the infinite series, we would have endless of halves in the series. This means the series would be infinite. Therefore, the harmonic series is divergent. This is a simple proof for the series. For the divergent harmonic series, we can see some mathematical tricks on the divergent series. In the next two slides, the first trick would be illustrated. For the series, the first step, we group the terms together as seen in this expression. Two terms in here, two terms in here, two terms in here, and so on. This is a very simple way to group two terms together. Of course, we can do this grouping in many different ways, and we will get a different result. But the final result should be same. So again, we can use the smaller value to represent the derivant terms. So, that's why we have the larger than sign here. And if we add this together, the value in the bracket, we have the expression as this. So we continue the derivation. As we shown in previous slide, the sum S would be given as this. And we can obtain the value as this. Regrouping the series, we have the result as this. And we can see in the brackets, we have a new harmonic series. And we can use S to represent the series in the brackets. So we have the result as this. If we put all this together, we obtain an expression for the harmonic series given as this. This is a very strange expression. If we add half to the series at the right-hand side, its value would be smaller than the original value. Mathematically, this is impossible. This means S would not be a defined number, and in this case, S is infinite. Because the expression infinite plus half is a meaningless expression. And if we compare the infinite and the infinite plus half, if we ask which is larger, this is not a question at all. In here, we will see an interesting mathematical trick on the divergent harmonic series, the second trick on the series. Step 1, we group the series into two large groups. The group with the odd numbers here, and the group with the even numbers here. The next step is take the half out of the series with the even number, see here. And then we can see in the bracket, we construct a new harmonic series in this bracket. So as such, we can replace this series with the sum S. So we have the solution for half of the harmonic series. It equals to the series with the odd numbers. Since the series with the odd number takes half of the harmonic series, see this equation 1, this means the series with the even numbers would take other half of the harmonic series, the equation 2. The equation 2 can be also obtained from the harmonic series directly by timing half to the series given as this. Now, if we compare equation 1 and the equation 2 term by term, we can see each term in equation 1 is larger than the corresponding term in the equation 2. See here, 1 is larger than 1 over 2, and the 1 over 3 is larger than 1 over 4, and etc. So put this together, we can see the sum in the equation 1 is larger than the sum in the equation 2. So if we put the expression for this comparison, we can see half s in the equation 1 is larger than half s in the equation 2. Why this is the case? Again, we can see s is not the defined number here, and more specifically, s is infinite. Because the series is infinite, so half of the sum is meaningless, and the comparison between equation 1 and equation 2 would be meaningless too. From this mathematical trick, we can also see the series with the odd numbers and the series with the even numbers are both infinite. Having talked about the divergent harmonic series, it is interesting to see how we can play mathematical tricks on the series. But the divergent harmonic series is generally not very useful. Instead, there are many convergent series, and some of them are actually very important in mathematics. Here in this slide, some simple and useful series are given. The first series is very similar to the harmonic series in this talk, but this one is called alternating harmonic series. So we can see minus sign is for the terms with the odd number. And we also see an interesting Leibniz-Mardewa series. This is an alternating series for the odd number. And it is interesting to see this series link the famous number pi here. Basically, this series would give an equation for calculating pi accurately. Euler series is an interesting series given in this form. It again links with pi here. And if we compare this series and this one, we can see for calculating pi, Euler series would be much faster to converge than the Leibniz-Mardewa series. And we have many more series